Hello YouTube people, let me show you the most beautiful watch that I ever had. This Cadisen beauty, the blue dial. Oh my gosh, still to this day I can't believe how beautiful this watch is. And I'm having this watch for 2 weeks now. So the initial impressions have worn out, but I still just love how this watch looks like. Incredible. Well, it's up to your taste, but for me this is the most beautiful watch that I ever had. So quickly, let's run down the specs. This watch, the size is 38 millimeters, thickness 11.6 millimeters, lug width 20 millimeters, lug to lug distance 46.2 millimeters, and all these measurements are done by myself. And it has sapphire crystal and the cyclop. Also, I have checked myself. It shows positive that it's sapphire. The crown is not screw down crown, but this watch still has 5 bars of water resistance. Bars, I mean, 50 meters, you could say. And it has very good bracelet. Solid links, solid end links, milled butterfly clasp. Clasp doesn't have micro adjustments, but these replaceable links are short enough and it's easy to find the size, at least for me, so I don't even need those micro adjustments with this bracelet. But about the bracelet a little bit later on. First of all, let's speak about the watch itself. Well, first thing which I would like to touch is this beautiful blue dial. It is so incredible, it's so deep, it's so rich. The only watch I could compare this dial to is Orient Ray 2, the blue dial. I would put them even, side by side, I would say. But Orient Ray 2 has that blue dial with slightly matte finish and slightly brighter blue. It looks a bit more sporty, Orient, while this Cadisen is a little bit deeper, darker blue, and a lot more shinier. It's a lot more dressier looking. So it's a different kind of blue, but in the terms of prettiness, I would put them on the same category. They both look absolutely incredibly beautiful. So speaking about the dial, how are these indexes and hands? Does the loom on this watch destroy the design? And the answer is no. The loom is applied in a nice way. It's pretty. It looks pretty good. And at least on the indexes, the loom is actually functional. When I come from the outside, come to the dark room, I see that these indexes are actually shining. But the problem is that only indexes. Hands don't have much loom. The loom on hands is very thin, it's barely noticeable, it's pretty bad. And the loom on this watch overall, I would say, is just for aesthetic purposes. Another thing which is kinda difficult to show, and I haven't noticed that thing right away, is that the inside of the case, these walls around the face of the watch are actually mirror finished. Polished to the mirror finished. And when you look at that angle to these inside walls of the watch, they look incredible. You can see mirroring those indexes and it's just so shiny, it's so pretty, and it's all under this sapphire crystal. It's great. I really like how it looks like. So about the case, how is this bezel? At first I was kind of afraid of this bezel because in pictures and videos it looks a little bit like a Christmas toy, all sprinkly, shiny, and I was thinking that it might cheapen the look of the watch, but in real life when you put this watch on the hand, it doesn't look cheap, it doesn't cheapen the look, it doesn't sprinkle shiny like cheap toy of some kind, it does look luxurious, it looks good, and it's finished very nicely, no sharp edges, everything comes very evenly, symmetrical and so on. It's beautiful. And coming around, the back case, yes, it has display back cover And the movement side, this is the cheaper option. There are two options. Is the this one golden, the cheaper option, and there is another option with Miyota movement, which is not pretty at all. But about the movement a little bit later. First of all, about the looks. It looks incredible. Wonderful finishing. Well, I'm not looking at it with macro lens of some kind, but with naked eye it looks really beautiful. Golden finish, and blue screws looks great. Another little thing which I would like to talk about is this Cyclop. In videos and pictures, it looks like the Cyclop doesn't even work. It doesn't magnify. But in real world, once you realize how small the actual window is behind that Cyclop, you understand that it actually magnifies. Not much, like 1.5 times, I would say. But yes, it does work. Yes, I wish it would work a little bit better. Do I care? Nah, not at all. I have no problem seeing small things. For me, Cyclop is not a necessity, but I do like how Cyclops look like on watches like this one. So about the watch, it's kinda it. Sides are, what haven't I mentioned yet? The sides are mirror finish, polished very nicely. The top of the lugs is brush finished. Also, can't really complain, looks pretty well. And everything comes together very nicely. I see no anything wrong about this watch. It comes very in a very beautiful, aesthetic, pleasing looking way. As I told you, it's the best looking watch I ever had, in my opinion. It's absolutely wonderful. And the size, 38 millimeters. On my hand, it looks just perfect. Absolutely perfect. I wouldn't go any larger than this one on my hand for this style of the watch. It looks incredible, really. I just love the size and the feel, everything. I just love it. It's great. So, let's move on to the next thing, which is about the bracelet. So, speaking about the bracelet, I saw a lot of YouTube videos about Jubilee bracelets. People complaining that it's very jingly jangly and it feels cheap and so on. And I was very surprised when I took this watch into my hands. First thing that I wanted to check, how is that bracelet? Is it really that bad? That, oh, speaking overall about the Jubilee bracelet, is it really that bad? I was very surprised that this bracelet feels the best quality bracelet of any bracelets that I ever had. I don't know. Orient Ray 2, Invicta Pro Diver. Well, I haven't had any high-end watches, but from all watches that I had, this is incredible. This bracelet, of course, it has some sound when you move it around, but it doesn't sound cheap. Doesn't matter what you do, and it's not loud. That's all the sound I can get from this bracelet. And when you move the watch on your hand, you have no sound whatsoever. Well, kind of a little bit, but like, that's it. No squeaky, no rattly noises. It's incredible. I mean, for this price, having this complicated bracelet to be finished in this beautiful way without any jangly noises. And all the edges are softened out. All the edges. It feels wonderful. These solid links, solid end links, everything comes together very nicely. Nothing. I can't think of a single complaint about this bracelet. I never had such a good bracelet. It's incredible. And moving on, let's speak about this clasp. I'm not the biggest fan of butterfly clasps because they don't have micro adjustments, but those removable links of the bracelet itself are pretty short. Basically, as long as micro adjustments would be on the normal clasp. So I can't complain because by removing these little micro links, I can find a size that fits perfectly fine my wrist. And it sits very comfortably on the hand. And I just love how easy to use this clasp is. Just two fingers on the clasp, that's it. The watch comes off. I love the convenience. And look just how quick it is to put it back on my hand. Just once you get used to that, it's so convenient, so easy to use. I just love it. Just take it off, that's it. Put it back on, that's it. I just love the convenience like that. I don't need to fiddle around to break my nails, to open some kind of, like a treasure chest of some kind. No, just push a button, that's it, it comes off. It's incredible, I love it. I love everything about this bracelet and this clasp and this watch. It's incredible. It's for this price point especially. Wow. But this watch has a very big negative point, which I'm gonna talk about right now. So I wouldn't have bought this watch for myself with this movement. I would go for a Miyota movement. But the story is that my friend got this watch. He did a review on this watch and he offered me this watch for such a good price that I just simply couldn't say no, whatever the movement inside is. So I took the opportunity and I'm happy that I did that, because I just love this watch, despite the fact that this movement is not very good. So I've read a lot of reviews about this watch on AliExpress, and I haven't found a single complaint about these golden movements. And so maybe it's the problem on my side, maybe I did something wrong, or maybe it's just one off bad unit. But at first the problem was that the rotor inside was getting stuck and the whole watch was getting stuck. You just shake a little bit the watch and that's it, it stops and stays stopped, and you have to shake several times again to get it going again because that rotor was getting stuck. So I opened the back and loosened a little bit the rotor, and everything is fine. It goes well, and the rotor moves freely, and the watch doesn't stop until it runs out of the energy, out of the spring energy, because the rotor doesn't wind anything. I don't know. Maybe I have broke something or something is wrong, because this rotor is very, very loose inside. I tried several times removing it, screwing it back. I tried different things, but it feels like this rotor is not connected to anything. It's just like fidget spinner. It just spins inside indefinitely, basically, and it doesn't wind anything. So I've tested how long this watch will run when I fully wound the watch. And how do I know that it's fully wound? When I keep wounding the watch, when it's fully wound, it starts clicking very quietly, but I feel through my fingers that it starts clicking a little bit. That spring inside starts to slipping, you know. It's kind of a prevention of overwinding the watch. So fully wound it, it lasted me something like 42, 45 hours, something like that. And then it stopped naturally, you know, it ran out of energy. And another thing that I have noticed is very strange. If I wear the watch and I keep it fully wound, it goes second to second, very accurate. And if I fully wound the watch, leave on the table, it gains several seconds a day. But what happens the next day when it starts running out of energy? So first day everything is fine, but second day it kind of loses like half a minute per day. So if I keep it fully wound, which is not a problem because it's not a screw down crown, so whenever I can just put my finger behind the crown and wind it up. It's very easy and it's kind of enjoyable thing to do as well. I like that kind of interaction with the watch, and it runs very accurately, no complaints. So maybe it's just one off unit that's bad. But I don't know, if I would buy it for myself, I would go for Miyota movement. Even though this one is the pretty one, I would go for Miyota. And I would advise you to do the same. Don't go for this golden movement. I don't know. Miyota should be better, maybe. So what's the verdict? What's the conclusions about this watch? Not much to say, really. I can tell you only one thing. You know, the way how I run this YouTube channel, I invested 1,000 euros into this YouTube channel, and I use that money to buy watches. I do a review, sell the watch, buy another watch, and I constantly have like 5 watches in rotation that I buy, review, sell, and that's how I bought this watch. Also bought from my dedicated YouTube money, not for myself, for YouTube. But this is actually the first watch which I bought from that account, from my YouTube dedicated money. But later on, I bought it out for myself. I bought it out from my YouTube channel to myself. Do you get the idea? That's how good this watch is. Yes, there are several watches that I initially bought for myself and did another review. And this one I bought for YouTube with my invested YouTube money. But later on, I bought it out for myself. So that's the conclusion. That's how good this watch is. That's it. Only nice things I can tell about this watch. It's a very, very pleasant surprise. I liked. So thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.